One of the most recognizable names and faces in the NHL hangs up his skates. It's Ty Domi, a tough guy in the NHL, retires from the game. There you go, 1998, along with Ty Domi, Mike Modano, Trevor Linden, Jeremy Roenick, Rod Brind'Amour, Teemu Selanne. Guys who are known for scoring goals, Ty Domi, a tough guy, 3,515 penalty minutes. Now on ESPN News Game Time, Ty Domi joins us from Toronto. Ty, you amassed over 3,500 minutes in penalties over your career. That's a lot of fighting. So any one fight you remember the most?
Well, obviously the Bob Probert ones when I was with the Rangers, those stick out definitely in my mind. Those were ones that were a lot of fun to be in, actually, believe it or not, and very memorable.
All right, that was early on in your career. So how about the toughest guy you ever fought?
Well, I'd have to still say Bob Probert and Dave Brown. Dave Brown, they both probably were rank up there as the toughest ever.
What made them so tough?
They're just so smart and big, and they had the reach, and they hit hard.
All right. Winning a fight or scoring a goal, what was more fun for you?
I think winning a game is the most fun.
And where would you categorize scoring a goal? How would you describe that for you?
Well, it's a good feeling. You know, it's always a good feeling to contribute, but the ultimate thing was to win games.
And how about
playoff games?
How about a fight versus a goal? A great fight versus a goal?
Well, you know, in the young days, the fights were something I always looked forward to, but it was just something part of the job that I always took care of my teammates.
Spoken like a true tough guy. Now, what happened that night in Philadelphia when you had an altercation with a fan?
Well, he poured beer on me, and, we kissed and made up now, but at the time, it was kind of a bizarre thing that happened, but he got in there, and it was like he got in a cage, and he started swinging, and he started hitting the linesman, so that's when I started getting involved, but, that's done and over with, and he actually is a good guy. We made up, and actually had him come to Toronto in a playoff game against the Flyers, and I took care of him and his family.
Wow, so you've made up with him, and you guys have an ongoing relationship. What's that like, man?
No ongoing relationship. We just patched it up, and he came into the city, into Toronto to watch against the Flyers. All right. I told him, let's keep it under the radar, but sure enough, every TV station had him zoomed in on the crowd, and that's fine. He got his limelight out of it, which was no problem with me.
And you showed you still have a soft side to you there. Now, we have a special guest who wants to say hi to you. Go ahead, special caller.
Ty, Rob Ray here.
Hey, Razor, how you doing?
How you doing? Hey, congratulations. You
Thank you very much.
Had a fine career, man.
Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it.
I think you're being a little modest there, Bull, with the fighting, though, because let's face it, if there wasn't fighting in hockey, neither one of us would have had a job.
That's for sure. No kidding.
No, that's great. You know what? It's something I heard that you were retiring, and you know, it's a sad time because you're the last of a dying breed. You're pretty much the only one left from the old days, and now
one of the last
gone,
dinosaurs.
One of the last dinosaurs. The game is going to be different out there for a lot of people. So,
well, it will. Those Buffalo-Toronto games won't be the same, Razor, without you and I. That's for sure.
The thing is, you can get a ticket now for those games. Before you couldn't. So, it's unfortunate.
That's true. But unfortunately, the game has changed with a lot of special teams, and the guys that played our role just aren't going to play that much, unfortunately, for the sport's sake, I think. But, everybody thinks the special teams are going to help, and the guys that aren't special teams, they should get paid the most now because they're the guys who are going to play the most.
Hey, you guys,
I'm a little disappointed, though. You got $800,000 to leave, and all I got was a boat and thrown out the door.
And then you came back. You should have given the boat back, too.
Forget that.
Well, I don't want no boat. I just want to, have a lot of fun and be on TV like you now, Razor. You're my idol.
Well, you've only got one obstacle you got to get over. You know, I'm a lot better looking, so I fit in. So
yeah, but at least I fit on the camera. They don't have to zoom in camera on me yet, Razor.
Well, you're exactly right.
Even in retirement, you guys are competing against each other. As you guys mentioned, you'll both be on TV. How's that going to work?
Well, we both actually were roommates when we got drafted, and when Rob got drafted, I was more excited for him when he got drafted. And that night, well, I don't want to say what we did, but he climbed up a telephone pole with his own hands. And he was swinging on it, so I don't know where he's from. He's from a farm somewhere, but that was quite an experience. I remember Rob Ray when he first got drafted. It was an exciting game. He made a great career out of it.
The thing is, we got an opportunity to watch an awful lot of hockey and a lot of good players, so now we can pass that on.
Yeah, and we're not going to sugarcoat like all those other people on the panel, are we, Razor?
That's exactly true. You got to be real, Ty. Be real.
You guys are going to keep it real. Thanks for keeping it real tonight here on ESPN News Game Time. Ty Domi, Rob Ray, thank you both. And Ty, congratulations on a great career.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
All right, the tough guy, the most fights in the NHL since 89, Domi's first season in the league. You see, he's got 270. Jeff Odgers, 242, and Rob Ray, 236. We heard from two of the top three right there. Not bad.
And we now bring in ESPN hockey analyst, the coach, Barry Melrose, to the show. And, Coach, we got one very simple question for you. Top five fighters of all time, where's Ty Domi?
Well, I put him at number five. I think people don't realize how small Ty Domi is. He's only about, he says 5'10", but there's no way he's 5'10". And he made a living out of fighting against guys 6'4", 6'5", 6'6". And most nights, he won most of his fights. So out of bravery, very smart fighter, very scientific fighter, Ty Domi gets number five.
All right, how about number four? Do the countdown for us.
Number four, I got to give Dave Schultz. This guy played the Philadelphia Flyers during the toughest era hockey's ever seen. Just a tough, tough time to play. Used to get 450 to 500 minutes in penalties, 40, 50 fights a year. Dave Schultz would be number four.
How about, now we're at the top three, Coach. Who's number three?
Marty McSorley. Marty was a very good player, fought everybody, fought during the toughest time the NHL has ever seen, fought all the tough guys, did very, very well, and also a very good player, has won Stanley Cups.
That leaves two spots, Coach. Top two fighters of all time.
Number two, and this might be a surprise for some people.
Nice, little Red Wings.
Because he doesn't get the ink, but Joey Coatser may be the most dangerous one punch in hockey. I played with Joey. I've seen him end careers. I've seen him hurt guys very badly. His right hand was deadly. I think anybody who had a choice to fight Joey Coatser or anybody else would take anybody else. Nobody wanted to fight Joey Coatser straight up.
So that leaves two, and I'm guessing it's Grimson or Probert. Who is it?
Probert's the best fighter ever in the NHL. He would have been the toughest guy in the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, and now. Smartest fighter, most endurance, could take a punch, loved to fight. And don't forget, this guy scored over 20 goals a couple times in the NHL, also a very good hockey player. But hands down, no doubt about it, if you talk to anybody with any hockey sense about toughness in the NHL, Bob Profford's the toughest guy that's ever played.
And how about the toughest guy you ever took on, Coach?
Bobby Nystrom gave me a pretty good licking one night in Toronto. Hit me with so many rights, I was begging for a left later in the fight.
You did have 728 career penalty minutes, Coach. We looked it up. 300 games played. You took care of yourself all right.
That's
Coach,
all. That's 350 tripping penalties.
We appreciate you joining us on ESPN News. Have a great night, Coach.
I'll see you guys in a couple weeks.
All right.